The topic is the role of a Muslim in the community. And of course, what I said is that Islam, philosophically, is based on community consciousness. If you pull out community consciousness from Islam, Islam collapses. And from the beginning, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, not asked, but he was helped by Allah, knowingly or unknowingly, to build a community. A community of Muslims called Ummah. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. When you read Surah Al-Baqarah, he's talking about Ummah. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. He addressed Muslims that you are an Ummah. An Ummah is a community of believers, a community of individuals who are under the bond of their religious consciousness. And in the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strategized for the Prophet. And he made sure that people like Bilal. Bilal represented everything African in his appearance, in his physiology, his hair, his whatever. Who he represented everything African. And then blackness, of course, before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we know that the blacks were respected. If you know the history of black, after Abraham was black, and after Abraham, his son Masroq also became a very powerful man. Then black people, then they were respected, they were honored. But of course, after that, something happened to us, and some historians are saying that maybe the mistake of Abraham, as well as the mistake of Ashabul Ukhdud, maybe we were humiliated and then took back and take our dignity and honor after that because of this. I don't know whether it's that true. But when the Prophet came, during that time, Bilal as a black man was not respected. Now Allah wanted to destroy that disrespect because of his color. What happened is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tamed Bilal. He converted to Islam in a way that you understand. All of you know the history, the story of Bilal. Bilal came to Islam and he represented a pillar of the Ummati pillar, one Ummati pillar. And it's a blackness, Africanity, but an African that should be respected like any other individual on earth. So the Prophet welcomed Bilal as part of the family. He said, Anawa wa Bilal haqqada bil Jannah. I and Bilal are like this in Al Jannah. People could not understand. You know, the mindset then, the computer, they could not understand how can a black man be equal to somebody like the Prophet. Why? Because the Prophet wanted to destroy this issue of ethnicity and color inferiority. Then also Suhaib al-Rumi, he was a Roman Sahabi who was also brought to the Prophet. He also converted, representing everything white. And then after that you have Salman al-Farisi. Salman from Faris, from Iran, represented everything Asian. And then you have the Arabs together. So that was a blend where you have people from Asia, people from Africa, people from Europe together, and Arabs. So they represented an Ummah. So there is no major, no minor, no higher, no lower. No, in Islam, there is no color inferiority, there is no ethnic inferiority. Everybody is equal to the other. And then that was reinforced by the verse which says, Inna akramakum indallahi attaqakum. La fadla li arabiyyin ala ajamiyyin illa bi taqwa. There is no major, no minor, no higher, no lower. There is no kind of distinctive characteristics because of ethnicity. Inna akramakum indallahi attaqakum. The best of you are those who are the most pious. And when Allah said that, some people started, you know, playing smart. They wanted to show that they are pious, and they, you know, don't dress like pious. The Prophet said, no, that is not the way. You cannot show piety in your dress. And even today, there are people who try that they are not pious because of they dress this way, that way. No. Piety is in the heart. In the akramukum indallahi attaqakum wa taqwa hahuna fa ashara ila sadrihi salasa marra. So piety is there in the heart, but it has to impact your organs. A pious man cannot steal. Why? Because you are observed and closely monitored by God. You are so conscious of God. You can't steal. A pious man cannot commit adultery. How can you commit adultery and steal? So piety has to have an impact, positive impact on your organs, and is an indication of piety. But I am biased and stealing. I am biased and drinking alcohol. I am biased and no, that is not. Piety is in the heart, but it has positive impact on your organs. Then this is the community base. Since this is the community base, Muslims anywhere should represent that. When you see a Muslim isolating himself, a Muslim who doesn't feed what Muslims feed, a Muslim who backbite Muslims, a Muslim who, then you know that there is something wrong with him. So that's why isolation, individualism, is not good in Islam. We have the concept of community consciousness. That is why we said that this basis of community consciousness must be respected as far as a Muslim is concerned. Then I talk about the importance of that for those that are in the United States, Senegambians and others. We have many, many, many guests here from other countries. I was told that some of them are from Algeria, some of them are from whatever. So we are all Muslims. So even though we have many Senegambians, but the address here is to every Muslim. I am saying now, because the topic is the role of a Muslim in the community. What is your role in the community in the United States? Now, I was in Atlanta, but before I came, I thought that, in fact, there is no attempt at all. You know, then I had this data in me, but when I went to Atlanta, this Mr. Fai, Lamy, he took me in a tour, and in fact, I started complaining because it was so cold. You know, Lamy would take me here and there, but he knew what he was doing. Then I said, oh, these are Gambians. And I saw that they're really successful. But then they need something to really reinforce that. What I saw is that some segmented, fragmented kind of individualistic attempt to sell this, to sell that. But these fragmentations should be pieced together if you want to have a positive impact as a community in the United States. I saw people selling here and there. But even those who are selling, they have some problems. I said that some of them are still Gambians in America. Of course, it's good to be a Gambian in America. If that culture of Gambia that you want to Americanize, or you want to Gambianize in America, but a bad culture in the Gambia, live in the Gambia. Customer care. We attended a shop, we wanted to do something, but the guy or the lady was like, I said, oh, she's still a Gambian in America. But I know in many countries, they are very good at customer care. So the customer is first, I think what they say in here. Customer is right. The customer is always right. But in the Gambia, the customer is not right at all. So the customer, you can come to the petrol station. Yeah, the customer, yes. You can come to the petrol station in the Gambia, and then you find somebody sleeping. You come with your car, and you want to buy petrol. You will sit there for 2 minutes, 5 minutes, come and say, there is no fuel there. And he laughs. He enjoys that. But he is working there. He gets his provision from that. Yet he is happy that there is no fuel. And then you come to a shop, also, you want to buy something, you can be there for 10 minutes talking to an hour. My friend, so customer care, we are retarded about it. So we need to now, we need to adopt the customer care as developed here. We leave those things in the Gambia. Another thing I realize is that in this country, there are still people hating each other using magic, using all this witchcraft, you know, bringing the roots from a tree, those things that Africans know in terms of black magic, in terms of, please leave it there. Right? Because you come to a country that are scientifically oriented, this scientific orientation should have impact on you, and then you blend that good culture in the Gambia and the good culture in the United States. And this is what we said, and also the importance of this topic. The paper is an attempt to introduce a contemporary model of community service and community development built strategically on the two faces of Islam, the face of Makkah and the face of Medina. The face of Makkah is very, very important. The face of Makkah is the face that connects you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the theological face. The face that cements you in your belief, in your faith. That part is the Islam of Makkah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spent 10 years in Makkah to build, to correct the corrupted worldview of the pre-Islamic Jahiliyyah. The pre-Islamic era was characterized by a lot of social ills, such as primitive concept of God, such as tribalism, such as disrespect for women. All of these things, the Prophet came and he found that the people are sick. Of course, why? Because if somebody fight for tribal reason, somebody disrespect women, somebody entertain primitive concept of God, they thought that God cannot reach. He doesn't know what is coming, what is going on here. Of course, they reach a conclusion through philosophical induction, through logical induction, that God must have existed. They also reach a conclusion that God must have been one. But they had a belief that that God who is one was so high that he doesn't know what is going on here. That is why the philosophers talk about God knowing the universes, but doesn't know the particulars. God knows how many galaxies, how many asaman, you know, his heavens, but he doesn't know, for example, whether you are sleeping or you are writing. So God does not know the particulars. This belief was a corrupted form that the Prophet ﷺ came to correct. So he built this confidence in Allah. The strong belief that Allah is the creator of the universe. He's an intelligent designer. He was able to create a group of individuals who were so cemented in their faith in Makkah. That's the face of Makkah. That is Vatican. It's a Vatican. That's why you see a fan. When you see a fan, the fan, and then you switch it on, the fan is moving around, but the fan is connected somewhere. Without that connection, it cannot move. So that is the heart that we connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the Vaticanity that we need, and the one that the Prophet built in Makkah. But that was not enough. The face of Medina was very, very important. The Prophet migrated to Medina not as a joke. You know, the migration was not just an accidental movement. It was a planned movement to represent the second phase of Islam, which is the phase of horizontality of Islam, the phase of dignity of Islam, the phase of sovereignty, the phase of independence. The Meccan phase was not independent. They were very pious. They were very cemented in faith, but they were very weak. But Islam cannot be a weak. That's why they moved to Medina. So these two phases of Islam, a Muslim should be them. A Muslim should be at the same time vertical and horizontal. You have to connect to Allah, but your benefit, people should feel that you are. So these two models, these two faces of Makkah, is the model, it is the two faces that my model is built on. Now, the question I said here is that the Gambians or Senegalese, do they belong in the United States? That question is important because some of us think that they don't belong. And if you spend about a year or two or 10 and 20 years, you have about, you know, kids here and the kids have about 20 years and then you still do not belong, then you can never do your responsibility because you think, okay, I don't belong here. Why should I do something good? No, you belong. You belong, why? Because the universe has been created by Allah. I have created the universe and opened it, and every individual is entitled to live in any piece of the land. That is the original thing. All these passports and visas and the borders, these are artificialized. These are artificial. But at the level of Allah, Allah is not interested. And when you die, when the angel come, they will not ask you your nationality. Where are you from? I'm from the Gambia. No. They will not ask you about that. You see, and of course, some of us we think that. Now when you go to our graves, it's a kind of joke. It's not a joke. We are going very soon. Yeah? We are going very soon. If you even live 100 years, you are going soon. And that's the real life. And there are very specific questions that they are going to ask you. Be ready for that. It's not like a Gambianness or Senegalese. No, they ask you certain questions. That's why Allah is not interested in geography. Allah is more interested in you being useful on earth. Where are you from? It's not his interest. That's why you belong in America, right? Because America is a piece of land that belongs to Allah. You are servants of Allah. That is why you have to do good in the United States. You feel that you are from here, and you sweat and be part of the community, be useful to the community because you belong. But those that feel that they do not belong, then they are chopped into pieces. You are neither Gambian nor American. You are not doing so. You don't belong to America. You don't belong to Gambia. Where are you from? And there are people who have identity crisis. They don't know where they belong. You belong. When you go back, of course, don't go and tell Dr. Jesus that, you know, we don't belong to Gambia anymore. Because of the fact that the earth belongs to every servant of God, any piece of the earth belongs to you. And you have to be useful. And the Quran says, وَالْأَرْضَ فَرَشْنَاهَا فَنِعْمَ الْمَاهِدُونَ. And then he said, فَفِرُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Compete to Allah. So when you go and seek for a visa to France or to United States or to any other country, why are you going there? You are going to God. You are going to be useful because every second of your life is important. When you die, every second of your life is important. That's why I don't think that you can waste your time of a year or two or a second in the United States thinking that you don't belong. You belong. That's why you should belong to your community and you should render service to the community where you belong. I said a Russian cosmonaut, he was traveling, he went to the galaxies and he came back. When he was asked, can you tell us your fascination? Can you tell us your experience? He said, oh, when I look at the planet Earth, I reach a conclusion that I don't know who created it, but he's an intelligent designer.
Wow.
He really knows the business. He said, everything is okay apart from the borders. Libya criminal border even. It's the borders that contaminate the planet. But without the borders, the planet will be fascinating. So then the borders, these are things that we have done for ourselves. But every individual belongs to every piece of the land. As long as you are there to be useful. That's why you have to understand that you belong to the United States. The sociological movement is very close to geological movement. You see, Allah is very wise, wallahi. The prince of the Prince Harry. What's the name, Harry?
Harry.
He married who? He married the lady, and of course, originally in the past they wouldn't allow. You see, the sociological movement is as divine as the geological movement. The way we move from place to place is destined by God. And Allah knows who is useful for where. Let me tell you that. Don't think that, sometimes we think that the geological movement is so natural that we don't intervene. Allah gave geologically people, for example, the seas and the oceans and the face of the earth changes from time to time. And we think that it's natural. The naturalists call it natural. We call it divine. But that geological movement is destined, is divine, but also the sociological movement is also divine. Don't you know that? The fact that a Gambian is living in the United States was destined a long time ago. Why? Because Allah distributes abilities. He knows that, okay, Dr. Mbai, who was originally in the Gambia, doesn't belong to Gambia for 30 years. The usefulness of Dr. Mbai, the usefulness of Makpa Ebu Jai, the usefulness of Ali Fai, is dedicated in the United States. So that movement, it's very important and it's very divine. Don't think that you choose your destiny. Don't think that you choose your place of where you travel. No, something is divine here. So the sociological movement is as divine as the geological movement. Because of the distribution of abilities, is also something that God does to make sure that life goes smoothly. So don't take it very light. Wherever you happen to be, this is where you belong and this is where your usefulness should be used. There is a writer a sociologist called Ibn Khaldun. Ibn Khaldun written many books, but the most important one is Muqaddima, the Prolegomena. In that book, he talks about the lifespan of states, and also he talks about the nature of man as a social being. Ibn Khaldun says that to be a human being, you need many hands. The clothes you wear and the food you eat, you need many hands. That's why you need people. Because if you don't have people, then your humanness is questioned. Because this clothes that I wear needs many hands. That's why I need those people. So if Mr. X dies and you are happy, then your life is affected. Because that part of life that he used to render you, that you can know before. That is why we have to understand that the next door, the next man, the next woman to me is also part of my life. And then you wish them the way you wish yourself. That's very important. And the issue of community consciousness is also seen in many verses in the Holy Quran. And I just quoted one. When you read Surah Al-Fil, the elephant, there is a verse or a surah called Elephant. And after كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل, when you read it and then you connect it to Surah Al-Quraysh, the Ilaha Quraysh, then you can see the importance of community, the importance of being in a community. Because Allah SWT tell the Prophet that I have destroyed the Kaaba, the Ilaha Quraysh, that is for the caravan of the Quraysh, for their community consciousness. And then after he says, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. And when you read also أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ, these verses and surahs will definitely tell you how important for people to belong to the community. Legi, talk to me in the water, be your tiny heart boy, the road to community consciousness and community service. Legi, so can you get for community? Am na fay jaar fan ngay jaar dafa am ñetti basis nit ki nga xamantene dafa bëgg def lu ko war ki bëgg def lu ko war fokk mu xam lu ko war te ki bëgg xam lu ko war fokk mu xam bopam ku réer sa bop do mëna xam lu la war parce que ku réer sa bop do mëna xam lu la war ci sa bop te ku mëna te ku xam lu ko war ci bopam do xam lu la war ci nit ñi. Kon nit fokk mu xam bopam, mana man bopam, mana man liko war ci bopam, mana man liko war ci nit ñi. Waaye nit ki bu réeree bopam la jeex. Moo tax dafa am ay crises yoo xamante ne moo tax yoonent yi ñëw. Dafa am ay crises, crise of consciousness, crise of conscience, crise of identity, crise yi moo tax yoonent yi ñëw. Am na nit ñoo xamante ne dañoo réeree seen bopp. Te nit bu xamut bopam du mën a xam li ko war te bu xamul li ko war ci boppam du xam li ko war ci nit. Am na ñu bëri xamul li leen war ci seen bopp kon dañoo yéene seen bopp ñoo ñu yàlla musal ci ñu réeree seen bopp. Lu tax na ñu réeree seen bopp waaye dañoo jokkoo mu teg ki xam boppam te man boppam te mooy yàlla. Wallahi kenn na fi ne muy yàlla moo xam boppam man boppam kon ku jokkoo moom ci man boppam ak xamam dana la xamal sa bopp dana la sa bopp boo bàyyee yàlla gannaaw nit bu yàlla jeexee ci moom jeex na xamatul boppam ratul boppam moo tax mu ne waman aada dikri fa inna lahu maishatan dankan wa naxsuruhu yowma alqiyamati aama qala rabbi lima xashartani aama wa qad kuntu basira qala kadalika atatka ayatuna fa nasitaha wa kadalika alyowma tunsa. Mu ne yonent bi maa ngi lay moytuloo nga ñëw nga mel nii alladina nasu llaha fa ansahum anfusahum wala takunu kalladina nasu llaha fa ansahum anfusahum. Ngir yàlla bu leen mel ni nga xamante dañoo fàtte yàlla, yàlla fàtte loo leen seen bopp. Ku fàtte yàlla rek yàlla fàtte loo la sa bopp moom ful la jooju la am. Am na ñu bari ñooy gis ñu ngi dox di ñëw na nga dem ni fekk bokkat yi bu ko dañoo fàtte yàlla. Kon nit ki bu buggee xam li ko war fokk mu xam boppam man boppam te bu buggee man boppam xam boppam fokk mu jokkoo ki xam boppam man boppam te mu yàlla subhanahu wa taala ki nga xam ne dafa jox yàlla gannaaw kon kooku du man boppam. Kon moo tax dikkir am solo, moo tax dikkir am solo wa man aarada an dikkiri bu ko defee borom xam-xam yi joxe ci lu bëri ci dikkiri ngay fàttaliku yàlla ñu ko fàttaliku dem nañ bane sax mooy yàlla la ngay fàttaliku yàlla moy yalla la day fatale bu yalla ndax yalla waro ko fatale diko fatale kon la ya'lamu inni lastu adkuruhu id kayfa adkuruhu wa lastu ansa yalla xamne dum koy fatale borom gor yalla pire ko waxon mune yalla xamne dum koy fatale kay na ah ay ki mo ngi wax ni mune nak la koy fatale ko dum koy fatale kon nit ki dafa nek ko xamantene lu lepp lu yeug rek war na ci gis yalla lolou lu am solo nga xamne lepp lu yeug rek nga gis ci yalla ñiko mel dara safatu len ci aduna wallahi lu wex ak lu saf sukkal la ñamal bu len xass ak ku len tag la ñamal seen ñoon nekati ñom day 35 day 35 de fi am ñu yalla de lolou man ñu la ñeef nek bu ñe borom xaliss bu ñe borom tour bu ñe borom bu rafet bu ñe borom ki ñi nga xamne dañu tok bu guddi ñu tegg seen julli di nelaw ba seen sikir yu toy ñoo nga wara ñe man ñu la ñeef nek wallahi wax ak ñoo ñoo xam yalla tamu goor ñoo xam dana mel na ñoo nit ñi nak amuñ ñi amuñ ki nga xamantene yow yalla mi yow mata manam am na ñoo xamantene yalla da ngui koy defal ci aduna ba lo joxoñ lo nit ñi joxoñ nga dag ko koku nak bo dimé ci mom itam ci walu ruu da nga dem ba lu nit ñi joxoñ nga dag nit ñi yewu am na ko xal lu wax yalla def wa ma la ko wax boko jippé sax yalla lay def am na ñu yalla sopp nga xamantene bo len méré yalla yak ah parce que dañu nekkal yalla ko xamantene bimu tuddo musta lek lu haram mom duko lek ko xamantene bu gisee jigen fa nek mu daal ma nga suma benn mam cheikhou dia dafa gis jigen goor bu yeen jigen ci teel mu daal ko ma dama fa nekkon fi tay ko bu yeen jigen ci teel mu ko wallahi la ko xamantene da koy dëgg xaaliss ñu ne xaalissa way ñu dëgg ci lako da joxe xaalissa xaaliss ki kay loolu njubali la ñu tok nak tébé dalasi kay yow la ñu délo tébé dalasi ñu ne njubali la ñu yow ñu ne ci ñu ko yéwal ñu